So the interaction which we are going to learn today is parasitism, the third interaction. Let's read from the NCERT first, then we will go through the notes also. So considering that the parasitic mode of life ensures free lodging and meal, we all know parasite is supposed to be forceful interaction from one organism on another organism. The organism on which a parasite survives is called as the host. So parasitic mode of life provides two benefits to the parasitic organism. First, it gets a free place to live in and free meal also. It is not surprising that the parasitism has evolved in so many taxonomic groups from plants to the higher vertebrates. So not just the animals, we even have parasitic plants also. And when we talk about parasites, we don't only have the lower form of animals, even the higher forms of animals have become parasite. So many parasites have evolved to be very much host specific. So when we say host specific, that means they can parasitize only a single species of host. This is called as a specific one-to-one relation. And this explains that whenever during the course of evolution parasites evolved, they developed such clear-cut type of characteristics that they could only parasitize a particular species. And they cannot make interaction with the other species. It is something like you have learned in the junior classes regarding mutualism. Even in the 11th class, you learned about the nitrogen fixing bacteria, that these bacteria make a single relationship with a particular species of the leguminous plant. So in the same manner, parasites also have developed a very much host specific type of characteristics so that they can only parasitize and completely depend upon a particular host species in such a way that both host and parasite tend to co-evolve. So we all know parasite wants to continue this mechanism of free lodging and free meal. So the host will try to develop features so that characters so that it can somehow get rid of the parasite. So whenever the host try to develop defenses against the parasite evolves the counter defenses so that it can easily parasitize even in the future the host organism. So NCERT says that they both have evolved together so that if the host evolves special mechanism for rejecting or resisting the parasite, then parasite has to evolve mechanism to counteract and neutralize the mechanisms which are developed by the host in order to be successful with the same host species. NCERT says that in accordance with their lifestyles, parasites evolve special adaptation. Now this can come in board exam. So there are four special adaptations which are written in the NCERT. So the adaptations which are developed by parasites are loss of unnecessary sense organ. Second is presence of adhesive organs or suckers to cling on to the host body. Loss of digestive system and high reproductive capacity. So when we read the NCERT, it is very clear that these parasites have developed, they have lost slowly the sense organs because they need not to respond to the stimulus because they are given a very safe environment inside the host's body. Remember, when we talk about parasites, maximum parasites are endoparasites. So they are given a very much clear and fine without any problem type of environment inside the host body. So they have slowly lost their unnecessary sense organs. Then they developed the structures to cling on or to attach to the body, inside the body, maybe muscles, maybe the alimentary canal, digestive tract of the organism. And so they need something to cling on to the body of the host inside the body. And then because they start obtaining food generally from the blood of the parasite of the host, so because they are obtaining digested food, they need not to have digestive system. So they have lost their digestive system, and to find opposite sex partner for sexual activity inside the host body is very rare. It's the rarest of the rare concept. That's why they have developed characteristics, especially the endogamy or something which is called as self-fertilization, because they have become bisexual in nature, example tapeworm. Tapeworm once enter into the human body through the beef meat or the pig meat, it does not wait upon another partner to come into the host's body because tapeworms are bisexual. So the egg of the tapeworm is fertilized by the sperm of the tapeworm, and thus it increases the reproductive capacity of these organisms. So NCERT says high reproductive capacity. If you link this topic with the 10th chapter of NCERT, in the 10th chapter, we have already covered, in the 8th chapter, we have already covered this concept regarding what are the features of the parasites. So when you read the page 146, we have already covered these things, that the pathogens, most of the parasites are pathogens. So when pathogens or parasites enter the body, they have to adapt to the new environment inside the host. So their adaptations are pathogens have entered. Once they enter into the gut body, they must know how to survive in the stomach, because stomach will carry a high acidic pH and resist the various digestive enzymes. And then in the same manner, there are adaptations which are possible so that they are able to even reproduce. So higher reproductive capacity they have got. The life cycle of the parasite often becomes complex. So complexity may arise because we all know that Plasmodium is a parasite which needs two hosts to complete its sexual reproduction life cycle. And that means it needs a human, which is a secondary host, and the mosquito female Anopheles, which is the primary host. So their life cycle becomes complex because they may involve one or more intermediate hosts or vectors so that they can easily reach up to the primary host. So to reach up to the female mosquito, the parasite has to reach, for example, Plasmodium has to reach human body.